Josh, I suppose we should say welcome to Swansea City.
Thank you.
How have your first few weeks been here?
Yeah, really enjoyed them. As I've said before, you know, it feels like home for me here. It's been sort of in the back of my mind for a long time coming here. And it's a club that, you know, I've really wanted to be part of. And, you know, it's a great team, a great set of players. So, yes, it's been good. It's exciting to for the season to start this Saturday.
And you mentioned there, you know, it's been in the back of your mind for some time. I think this club has had interest in you previously as well. Is it something you sort of always anticipated would happen at one stage?
Yeah, as I've said, yeah, the interest was there for a while. It was just time. You know, I had great few seasons in League 2, League 1. And yeah, the opportunity came up this year and, you know, I sort of took it by both hands, really. And yeah, I was really happy to come here, and the decision for me and my family was a no-brainer, really. So, yeah.
You say it was a no-brainer. I mean, what were the things that about this club and, you know, the football they play and everything else, what made it a no-brainer for you?
Well, first of all, the philosophy of the football, you know, they play really pretty football. And, you know, in coming up through the academy next to, it was very similar in how we were taught to play. Obviously, Grimesy being an Exeter lad too, you know, it helped my decision. And yeah, just, you know, the philosophy, the facilities we have at the club, and it affirmed it my first week here. The lads have been really good with me, and we're creating a real, like, sort of togetherness in the team. So to be part of that, you know, is what any player sort of wants, really.
I'm glad you brought up Matt Grimesy. He was on the list. So, you know, in terms of him, an experienced player, and as you say, that link with Exeter as well, what's he sort of told you about this club before you came? And, you know, to play alongside a player like him must be good as well.
Yeah, I've obviously heard a lot about him being at Exeter as well. You know, he was talked about there a lot. And, you know, you see those players do what he's done, and, you know, it's sort of your dream to do the same thing. So to just be able to follow in his footsteps is a good thing, first of all. But even being here, you know, he's helped me a lot settle in. And he's a good character I've around the change room. So, yeah, he's made it really easy for me. And, yeah, it's nice to finally be playing beside him. So.
And you mentioned playing League 2, League 1 at your former club, up into the Championship now. I mean, for you personally, it's a big step up. Mm. You feel ready for it?
Yeah, I think, you know, I think I've said to people the difference between League 2 and League 1 isn't huge, but I think it's definitely a jump from League 1 to Championship. And you look at the standard of the league this year, it's kind of like a mini Premier League. So training's been good. It's been tough, but I'm someone that always wants to grow and push myself. So I think the environment I'm in now with the players we've got is a top bunch. So, you know, I think I see myself improving a lot and, you know, in a good team. So it's always good to be part of a good team.
And you referenced training being tough already. You know, Michael Duff, your new manager.
Yeah.
His first season here as well. How have you found life under him so far?
Yeah. I mean, what I'll say is every time I've played against his teams, it's never been an easy game. So when he was at Cheltenham, when he was at Barnsley. So for him to come in here now and play for it, you know, I know that we'll be a tough team to play against. And to be on, obviously, his side of it, you know, I think we'll be, yeah, as I said, a tough team to play against. And, you know, he's been really good with us, and I think he's implementing his style, but also keeping, you know, the technical side of what they had last year here. So, yeah, it's been good. Obviously, you never know how the first game's going to go, but I think, you know, we've worked on the things we need to work on, and tomorrow is just the final bit of prep to take into Saturday.
And earlier this week, the manager, he referenced the fact that every team in this division is aiming to get up into the Premier League. Swansea, one of those who feel that as well. As a player, is that what the squad's targeting this season, top six and ideally promotion?
Yeah, I mean, you said it there, you know, we were 3 points off playoffs last season. And, you know, I think top six has got to be anyone's aim. No one's going to go into a start of a season not wanting that. But, yeah, we've got to wait for the first game to come yet. So we're never going to know how it's going to start. But I think usually after sort of 10, 12 games, you know where you're going to finish. But I think our mindset is very much just take every game as it comes. You can only beat the team that you're playing on the weekend or on the Tuesday. So just really looking forward to that now and prepping for that. So it'll be an exciting game and we're really looking forward to it, yeah.
You teed me up really nicely there, Josh. Birmingham first on Saturday, your first home competitive game for your new club.
Yeah.
How are you looking forward to that? And, you know, what sort of threats are they going to pose? Because they've had a very busy summer as well.
Yeah, they've had a very busy summer. They've recruited well. We know that they're sort of, well, they're quick players, especially on the side. So wherever I'm playing, you know, it will mean that if I'm playing in my position, I'll probably be coming up against a quick winger. So You know, we've just got to look at ourselves, try and nullify their threat, and then implement the things we've been working on. You look at our pre-season games, you know, they haven't probably been the results that people want, but pre-season's about learning and working on the things you want to implement in the season. So I think we showed a little bit in Reading last week about what we can do. And I know it's only a League One club, but, you know, you can only beat what's in front of you. And I think that will be the style of football that we're going to try and play this season. It's a mix of what we had last year and what we're going to bring this year. And yeah, I think to answer your question, just, yeah, really looking forward to it and try and play the way we want to play first. So.
You reference your position there. You played on the left in that game at Reading. Mm. You can play on both sides as well. Have you got a preference? And, you know, appreciate as much as you are versatile, you want to play in a certain spot, I imagine.
Yeah, of course. You know, I think I've always been a player that's played on the outside of the pitch. So I'd like to say I can do both sides. So however I can get on the pitch and play and start on a weekend, if that's left or if that's right, or if that's up front or at the back or in goal, I'm happy and I'll give my all and try and get the job done. So we'll see where I start on the weekend, and I know that wherever I'm playing, you know, I'll do what I can to help the team win.
And a couple of new faces in this week, Carl Rushworth, and I'm going to call him Miko for now, just in case I pronounce his name incorrectly.
Yeah.
How good has it been to have, you know, a couple more fresh faces in for what is a really grueling start to the season in terms of games?
Yeah. You know, you never want a small squad, and I think I'd like to say with myself signing here, I think we've recruited well this year. But obviously it's important we have the team and the squad depth, and I think, you know, there's a lot of time left in the transfer window, so there's probably more players that will want to come in, but I don't know. We just get on with the football. We're not really told much. New players, new faces come in and you greet them and then they become part of your team. So as long as, I think the important thing is that we all stick together, get to know each other. And, you know, a winning team is always a team that's together. So I think it's important this year that we really bond well and go through the season together, yeah.
For yourself personally, Josh, you know, fans had a glimpse of you in a couple of the pre-season games, but, you know, you referenced it there, you know, a top signing for this football club. What can fans expect from you this season?
I think, first of all, I think my mindset's always to give everything, not leave anything on the pitch. And I think whether I'm having a good game on the ball or not, I'll always do my absolute all to try and get us the points, whether that's defending or running to make a last minute tackle. But then I like to say, you know, my attacking threat as well from deep, getting the ball, taking on players and getting crosses in the box, hopefully contributing to a few goals as well. I should have scored a few more last season, so hopefully this year I can chip in with that a bit more too. But yeah, at the end of the day, is whatever I can do to help the team win, I'll do it. So yeah.
And lastly from me, Josh, Joel Pirro, we got another two goals last week. You know, this club know how special he is, a talent at the Championship. Mm. A lot of noise about what may happen with his future, but for the time being, he is a Swansea player. Mm. How key is he going to be in these first few games and, you know, ideally beyond from your point of view?
Yeah, he's a top player. I couldn't believe the other day when I found out he's only 23, 24. But yeah, he's obviously a very important part. And I think even, you know, to take the light off him, the players we brought in, they can do the job just as well. But, you know, when you've got a special player on your hands like that, you obviously want to keep him. So whether he stays, wherever he goes, you know, that's not what we've got to think about. We've just got to try and utilise who we have got. Thankfully, at the moment, he's here. So let's try and keep him and use him for as long as we can. But if not, then, yeah, we'll see what happens. But, yeah, as I said, you know, we can only focus on what's in front of us. We can't focus on anything external. So, yeah, just we're blocking out the noise and being thankful that we've got them at the moment. So,
top man. Thank you very much, Josh.
Cheers, mate. Thank you.